This week on Cracked Science, while the vitamins in carrots won't give you night vision, there is a case to be made for some vitamins helping older people with their vision. Hey, this is Jonathan Jerry, and you're watching Cracked Science, the show from the McGill Office for Science and Society that separates sense from nonsense on the scientific stage. What? You can't see my face. How about now? Oh, good. Now, for some people, this black blob covering my face actually didn't go away. That's because it's the main manifestation of a disease called AMD, or age-related macular degeneration. When we talk of blindness, we often imagine people with no light perception, like Stevie Wonder, Ray Charles, or Geordi LaForge on Star Trek, a blind character whose visor made the character sighted, but actually blinded the sighted actor. But there are degrees of blindness, what we call low vision, and the leading cause of visual disability in the industrialized world is this disease called AMD. One in every 25 Canadians has this disease, and this number will keep rising because the baby boomers are, well, no longer babies. They're getting old. That black blob you saw over my face earlier, which some of my detractors might call a blessing, is actually called a scotoma. It's a blind spot right where you don't want one, and it's the hallmark of AMD. Age-related macular degeneration is one of those does exactly what it says on the tin diseases. It's all in the name. It's age-related, meaning that it affects older adults. It's a degenerative disease, meaning that it gets worse with time, and it affects the central portion of the back of the eye known as the macula. This small patch full of photoreceptors is what's needed for us to see well enough to read, drive, and ensure we're kissing the right person. So once you have it, what can you do? There are different treatment options, and I would never hear the end of it if I didn't mention rehabilitation, because I also work in that field. But I want to focus on what some people in the peanut gallery are screaming right now. Carrots! If these people want to see better, they need to eat more carrots.
Oh, carrots are divine. You get a dozen for a dime. It's magic.
No, carrots aren't magic, and you may think this is a joke, but actually, we need to talk about vitamins, like the beta carotene present in carrots. As much as vitamins and supplements have gotten a bad rap from people like me and other science-minded individuals who keep repeating that most people don't need to take them as supplements, especially if they eat right, there is a case to be made for certain supplements in certain conditions. Case in point, AMD. If you have the disease, you may be familiar with the brand names PreserVision and Vitalux.
When I found out I had age-related macular degeneration, AMD, I wanted to fight back. My doctor and I came up with a plan. It includes PreserVision.
It's a complete multivitamin, specially formulated with vitamins and minerals to help reduce the risk of AMD.
These brands offer a combo platter of vitamins, minerals, and other molecules known as the AREDS regimen. Now, this is not the wishful thinking of a naturopath. This specific combination has been tested in large clinical trials, and it has been shown to do something quite interesting. It can help slow down the progression of intermediate AMD to advanced AMD. And it's important to repeat what it can do. It can help slow down the progression of intermediate AMD to advanced AMD. It can't reverse the course of the disease, nor can it prevent the disease in the first place. I mentioned beta-carotene earlier, but this vitamin has been replaced by lutein and zeaxanthin because beta-carotene has been shown in the meantime to increase the rate of lung cancer in smokers. Now, you might think this is pretty straightforward. If an ophthalmologist sees a patient with intermediate AMD, they whip out their prescription pad, get them on this AREDS formula, and that's it. A mild, all-natural brake pedal to slow down the disease. But this is exactly where the story gets particularly interesting. Because you see, not everyone responds to the AREDS formula. So researchers wanted to figure out how to identify the people who did and the people who didn't. Enter Mr. DNA. While there are things you can do to decrease your risk of getting AMD, things like not smoking, eating well, and reducing your alcohol consumption, there are specific changes to your DNA that can increase your risk, and you have no control over those. Now, what if people with AMD who have mutation X were to respond very well to the AREDS formula, but people with AMD who don't have mutation X in their DNA were to not respond to it, or do worse when taking the formula. This is called pharmacogenetics. Many studies and many analyses of the data generated by these studies have been conducted over the years to see if this is true or not. And to be honest, it kind of looks like a particularly heated game of tennis. If these studies, which came out over the past 10 years, were to be released within the span of 10 minutes, they would make a news anchor lose their mind. Breaking news tonight, as a team of researchers demonstrates that certain mutations in the genes CFH and ARMS2 can alter patients' response to the AREDS formula, although all groups benefit from it. Wait, actually, a new study shows that zinc, which is present in the AREDS formula, accelerates progression of the disease in patients with certain mutations in the CFH gene. Actually, breaking news, a different group of researchers is claiming that a re-examination of the original data shows no effect of these mutations on whether or not the AREDS formula works. These early studies were wrong. They have failed to be replicated. I am getting word that the first group claims the second group's analysis is no good. The second group is digging in their heels and saying their analysis is top-notch. Breaking news, a new clinical trial conducted in France shows that your genes do have an effect on how you respond to a different formula that includes vitamin E. And another group just finished reanalyzing the results of the very first AREDS trial, and yes, they are also confirming that specific mutations in your DNA will be associated with a better response to the regimen. I'm glad that's settled. Now, you've got to be kidding me. Breaking news, three groups mediated by the National Institutes of Health have just published yet another analysis of the original AREDS trial data, and well, there's no association between your genes and how you respond to the AREDS supplement. They're saying everyone with intermediate AMD should get the regimen. Are we done now? Are we done yet? Are you kidding me? It was revealed that some of the members of the initial research group that was pro-genetic testing work at the genetic company that sells a test. They are now accusing some of the people who are against the test of benefiting financially from sales of the AREDS regimen. And breaking news, the CEO of the American Academy of Ophthalmology claims an independent analysis of the data, untainted by financial interests, shows there is no link between a person's genes and their response to the AREDS formula. He said that, quote, "This issue has, over the past several years, pitted clinicians against each other, led to allegations of scientific misconduct, and prompted threats from lobbyists," end quote. But he claims, quote, "We now have an answer, and it is a clear victory for the scientific process and for patients," end quote. When asked for comments, the people who are pro-genetic tests said, "Sir, we respectfully disagree." If you ask me whether or not people with intermediate AMD should receive a genetic test before being prescribed the AREDS supplement, I wouldn't know what to tell you. But the reason why I brought it up is simple and quite important. Science is never perfect. We'd sometimes like to think that researchers set out to provide a definitive answer to a question, that they conduct a single experiment and they get a clear, unambiguous answer. That is almost never the case. Science is dirty and imperfect, and it slowly lures us toward the truth that can be touched but never fully grasped. And clinicians must make decisions based on this imperfect body of work. This is why medicine often consists of probabilities and judgment calls. Science and medicine, it sometimes is, if you'll pardon the pun, a little bit like the blind leading the blind. So, to wrap up, the AREDS formula does seem to slow down progression of intermediate AMD. But whether or not some patients, because of their genetic makeup, benefit even more from it, or are actually harmed from it, remains an open question in my book. And we will need our brightest minds to sort it out.
Come on, boffins, let's sort this out once and for all. What do we reckon, Richard?
Well, as usual, Raymond, you've raised an absolutely huge question.
Of course I have, Richard, this is big talk. Now let's get this sorted once and for all.
This video series is one small part of what our office does, so go to mcgill.ca/OSS to see what else we do to help separate sense from nonsense, and do subscribe to our newsletter. You can follow me on Twitter @CrackedScience, and join us next time for science that may or may not be all it's cracked up to be.